Hello, my name is Joseph Crippen, and I'm a tenor in the National Lutheran Choir. I'm also the pastor of Mount Olive Lutheran Church in Minneapolis. The National Lutheran Choir would like to wish you all a very blessed Advent and Christmas time, and we're delighted that you are joining us via this live stream. In the next hour or so, we will all be drawn out of the stream of our everyday lives and the challenges and pains and fears into a new space, a space that opens up the possibility of joy and trust that God has come to be with us in this world. And as we will sing at the end of our program, a prayer that God will stay with us and go with us out into the fears of our lives and the struggles and the joys that we experience. Music sung through human bodies and with human words of longing and hope sneaks into our hearts and opens up a space where we're able to realize that God is already with us and that God will carry us through this life and into a place of peace and hope. The National Lutheran Choir wants to make this concert available to any who would like to hear it without cost. If this has moved you in any way tonight, if you are brought to a sense of hope and peace through our singing, we invite you to consider making a gift to the National Lutheran Choir through the way that is described on this screen. Once again, thank you so much for being with us as we sing our Christmas festival concert. And may this be a blessing to us all that we will carry out into the winter of this world and our lives to bring healing and hope.
To everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven. Under heaven, under the stars of night, under the swirling clouds of the Orion Nebula, where even now new stars are coming to birth. There is a movement to this universe, a flow, a becoming. The night sky tonight will not be exactly the same night sky as yesterday. There is a movement to this life, a flow, a becoming. The interstellar clouds swirl and meander around each other like a river through a canyon. Newness around each bend, the river changing, the canyon becoming, new stars forming. Our lives meander and crash through the stardust and take on glory. There is a movement to this life, a flow, a becoming, a new heaven, a new earth. I love Jesus who said to us, heaven and earth will pass away. When heaven and earth have passed away, my words will still remain. What was your word, Jesus? Love? Forgiveness? Affection? All your words were one word. Wake up.
Wake awake, for night is dying. The watch will
The wisdom,
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 wisdom.
sang. Let me chant to you a truth before time. O Mary, let me sing into your heart a truth before space. There is no space where I am not. O Mary, God sang, life is holy. Call and answer, Mary's face shone. Mary's consent opens the door of created nature, of time, of history, to the Word of God. The shadows fall, the stars appear, the birds begin to sleep. Night embraces the silent half of earth. A vagrant, a destitute wanderer with dusty feet, finds his way down a new road, a homeless God, lost in the night, without papers, without identification, without even a number, a frail, expendable exile, lies down in desolation under the sweet stars of the world and entrusts himself to sleep. Should you hear them singing among stars or whispering secrets of a wiser world, do not imagine ardent, fledgling children. They are intelligences old as sunrise that never learned right from left, before from after, knowing but one direction into God. But one duration, now. Their melody strides not from bar to bar, but like a painting hangs there entire. One chord of limitless communication. You have heard it in the rhythm of the hills, the spiraling turn of a dance, the fall of words, the touch of fingers at the rare right moment. And these were holy, holy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Come from the glory, he comes from the glory.
ages after the world was created, when God, in the beginning, formed the heavens and the earth, long after the great flood, some 2,000 years after the birth of Abraham, 15 centuries after Moses and the passing over of Israel, 1,000 years after the anointing of David as king, in the 65th week, as Daniel's prophecy takes note, in the 194th Olympiad, the 752nd year from the founding of the city of Rome, the 42nd year of Octavian Augustus's rule, in the 6th age of the world, all the earth being at peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God, Son of the Father, willing to hallow the world by his coming in mercy, was born of the Virgin Mary of Bethlehem in Judea. God made flesh.
God showed me in my palm a little thing, round as a ball, about the size of a hazelnut. I looked at it with the eye of my understanding and asked myself, what is this thing? And I was answered, it is everything that is created. I wondered how it could survive, since it seemed so little, it could suddenly disintegrate into nothing. The answer came, it endures and will ever endure because God loves it. And so everything has being because of God's love.
Thank you.
Late have I loved you, O beauty so ancient and so new. Late have I loved you. For behold, you were within me, and I outside. And I sought you outside, and in my unloveliness fell upon those lovely things that you have made. You were with me, but I was not with you. You called and cried to me to break open my deafness, and you sent forth your beams, and you shone upon me and chased away my blindness. You breathed fragrance upon me, and I drew in my breath and do now pant for you. I tasted you, and now hunger and thirst for you. You touched me, and I have burned for your peace.
Thank you.
am the blossom pressed in a book, found again after 200 years. I am the maker, the lover, the keeper. When the young girl who starves sits down to a table, she will sit beside me. I am food on the prisoner's plate. I am water rushing to the wellhead, filling the pitcher until it spills. I am the patient gardener of the dry and weedy garden. I am the stone step, the latch, and the working hinge. I am the heart contracted by joy, the longest hair, white before the rest. I am there in the basket of fruit presented to the widow. I am the musk rose opening unattended, the fern on the boggy summit. I am the one whose love overcomes you, already with you, when you think to call my name.